I would like to give you one of my music appreciation talks out of the series Wind Instruments I Have Known. Today we shall discuss this one. I used to ask the audience to guess what, but I don't anymore because some of the guesses... No, I'm not surprised you don't recognize it because this is an undressed bagpipe. This part never appears in public unless fully clothed. But first of all, we have to treat the bag so it will be airtight. You fill it with a solution of one part water, one part molasses. Blackstrap, of course. That's where Gaylord Houser got the idea, because look what it's done for this old bag. Then you cover it in its little shirt, which should be made of the family tartan. I belong to the McPimple clan. It's the only Scottish clan to have a polka-dotted tartan. There we are. Now it looks a great deal less like what you thought it looked like before. Next, we put on the drones. They are called after the male or bumblebee. They make a great deal of noise, but they only do one thing. There. Next, you put on the chanter or chaunter. Now, this you play the tune on by twiddling your fingers on those little holes. Do you see? This has a double reed. And it goes in this end. Then finally, you have the insufflation or blowpipe. Now, if you will notice, this has a little valve on this end so that you can blow the air in and then you suck to shut the valve and keep it from coming out again. Only be careful. There is the complete instrument. I mean, I ask you. As to what notes it plays, it's rather a moot point because according to the Encyclopedia Britannica, out of which I may say I get all my material, the notes of the bagpipe correspond to no known diatonic scale because they are strictly not in tune with one another. On the other hand, A.J. Ellis, in his treatise on the bagpipe, says they correspond to the scale of Zalzal, a well-known Arab lutenist who died in the first century. So I don't imagine he's going to come up and give us an argument. Now, the way it works is, you see, you blow through there, which fills the bag, and then you squeeze the bag, and that blows all these other things, and they all go off at once. In fact, you might say it works on the blow, suck, push, twiddle method. And you have to be very careful to get it in the right order, because if you twiddle before you push, it just makes sort of squealing noises. And if you push before you blow, the whole thing collapses. And you have to start all over again. Now, everybody thinks that this is just the Scottish national instrument, but this was not originally so. In ancient Rome, they had a collegium utriculorum for studying the bagpipes, or as they are called in Latin, utricolores. And it says that the Emperor Nero himself was a very fine bagpiper or utriculator. If he'd done it when Rome was burning, it might have changed the course of history. Then the Germans also have the bagpipe or doodle sack. But this comes in five sizes: the Bock, the Grosser Bock, the Himmelchen, the Sackpfeife, and the Dude. But the Dude, in addition to all these things, has two chanters on it so you can play duets with yourself. Of course, naturally, you have to blow twice as hard. Have you noticed that so much connected with German music needs so much more wind than anybody else's music? I bet in those days they had doodlesack quintet chamber music groups. They probably had a little group going touring called Pro Musica Utricolores. Actually, you know, the bagpipes didn't get to Scotland until late in the 17th century, and they were brought there by an Italian called Giuseppe Aroni. And he liked it so much in Scotland that he stayed there and changed his name to Macaroni. You can't just put these things together and start playing them right at once, you know. You have to go through a period of tuning them in. This has a great deal in common with pipe smoking, that there's far more fiddling around with the equipment than there ever is in using it. Because, you see, when you start, it just makes squealy noises. And then a little later, maybe the drones will come in, but the chanter won't work. And then you work a little further, the chanter comes in, and the drones go on the fritz. And then finally, you get the chanter and the drones to work at once, and the bag leaks. But nonetheless, you have to play it every day, because if you don't, the molasses dries out. And if the molasses dries out, everything falls off them. Oh, well, you can't win with this. They're used on Scottish ceremonial occasions to pipe in the haggis, which is a Scottish national dish consisting of the heart and liver and general insides of a sheep, mixed up with oatmeal and whiskey and served in a pig's stomach. All the time, the pipers pipe ceremoniously around the dining table. Probably to keep your mind off what you're eating. And now I'm going to play something. Goodness knows what, but something. See what happened? I twiddled before I pushed.